Trying some new technology here to see if I can broadcast from my home. And I tell you what, I love it because I don't have to make that trip into Washington, D.C. So I really hope everything works out very well. And if you're watching this show tonight, then you know everything worked out very well. Well, listen, before I get started tonight, you know, just like I always do, I have to acknowledge my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And listen, I acknowledge that God is God all by himself. And I acknowledge Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. And I acknowledge the Holy Spirit as my guide and my comforter. Now, for those of you who want to know why or how to become saved, how to become part of the kingdom of Jesus Christ, you know, how to ask him to forgive you for all of your sins and start a whole new life. Well, listen, all you have to do is go to Romans 10 and 9. And it says, confess with thy mouth the Lord is Jesus, and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, and you shall be saved. Hey, listen, you don't have to be perfect. You don't have to earn your way. There is only one way, and that is through Jesus Christ. So I don't care how much money you have. I don't care how good you think you are. I don't care what sins you have committed, no matter what you've done. Jesus Christ is ready to forgive you for your sins and give you a whole new life, not only in this world, but in the world to come. Okay? Well, listen, folks, got a great show for you tonight. You know, over the next few weeks, I'm going to be talking about different things, and I really want you to get ready, because I'm going to help you really explode your business going into 2017. All right? Now, for those of you that are seeing the show for the very first time, okay, and most of you that probably watched my show in the past know that I've been in network marketing for over 40 years. But one of the things I'm doing now is I'm changing the dynamics, I'm changing the image of the network marketing industry, and I'm giving it a new name, and we're going to start calling it Exponential Marketing. Now here, I call my show now the Exponential Hub Show, which stands for Home-Based Business Show. And but the reason why I call it exponential, because we fall into that same business category of Uber or Airbnb or like Facebook and Twitter. These are companies out there that have gone from zero to $1 billion, and they don't own any assets. They have not really purchased anything. They're using resources that's already available. And the network marketing industry, as we know it, pretty much, we do the same thing. But because we had such a bad rap, because of all the negative stuff that's been printed about over the last 30 and 40 years, it's changed that time that we change and evolve and keep up with the times. If you take a look at a lot of your restaurants and different businesses, they rebranded themselves. They got new logos and new color scheme and a new look. You know, most businesses go through that phase where they change things. And we need to do the same thing. So if you're in network marketing, listen, I want you to help me spread the word and say, we're not in network marketing or multi-level marketing anymore. We're calling strictly exponential marketing, right? And companies that you know, like Mary Kay, Amway, Five Links, Ambit, these types of companies, these are exponential. These are just regular companies that use exponential marketing to market their services. And what I mean by that is that if you take a company like McDonald's, McDonald's advertises on television and on the radio, and they've been doing it for years. And in fact, McDonald's spent more money in marketing probably than just about any company. And that's why they're so big. They spend the most money in marketing, and they make the most money in marketing. But here's my point. Even though McDonald's use television and radio, they don't say they in the television or radio business. They are in the restaurant business. Some people would say that they are in the real estate business because every time they open up a McDonald's, it is on prime real estate right off of 95, somewhere close by on the main road. But my point to you is just because they advertise their business through the traditional way of advertising, such as television and radio, maybe newspaper, well, that doesn't make them in the advertising business. It doesn't make them in the radio business. It doesn't make them in the television business. So my point to you is just because a company that sells products and services decide to market their products and services through independent representatives, okay, which we use a exponential marketing concept because we can spread the word of a product or service much faster than any other source that's out there, whether it's television or newspaper or radio, that doesn't make them a network marketing company. Mary Kay is in cosmetics. She's a cosmetic company. Five Links, they are in the telecom. They're in the telecom business. Ambic Energy, they are in the gas and electricity business. Or you could go to Prepaid Legal or Legal Shield. They're in the legal services business. But we, as individuals, we are in exponential marketing. That's what we do. By building an organization, okay, that can spread from my home to hundreds and thousands and tens of thousands of homes all over the entire United States. So tonight, what I want you to understand is that we are talking about starting you an exponential hub. And that is a e-home-based business. And we're going to talk about some of the parameters around that. Now, for a very long time, you know, we have heard a lot of negative stuff again about network marketing. And this is one of the reasons why we got to change. We got now focus on the next generation that's coming behind us. We got to give our industry a facelift. Now, there's a lot of people that's giving me pushback because they done written books, magazine articles. They've been doing it for 10, 20, 30 years, and they done gotten used to it. Well, hey, listen. Just because McDonald's changed the design of their building, maybe changed the color scheme and changed some logos and things, the content is still the same. The food is still good. It still works the way that it's supposed to. And what we're going to be doing is pretty much still the same. All we're going to do is give it a facelift. And we're going to make things a little bit better so that when people go and Google and go and do research on exponential marketing, not only are they going to see our companies, but they're going to see companies like Uber and Airbnb and Facebook and all these other social media type companies. These are exponential companies also. So we are in that category, okay? Now, why should you own one? Because, listen, when you take a look at the economy and the way it is today, and all the different things that's taking place where you cannot retire at a traditional job. Listen, if you don't have a backup plan, a plan B, and that's exactly what this is a plan B, because we don't want you to replace or stop doing what you're doing. I mean, we got a lot of professionals out there that really love their work, and you should continue to do that, all right? But there's nothing wrong with you being able to start yourself a home-based business so you can take advantage of all the benefits that come with it, which I'm going to tell you more about. And for all of you potential e-hub owners, home-based business owners, for those of you that have already seen a presentation and you might have seen it a week ago, a month ago, maybe a year ago, and you just tuned into my show, listen, you need to get back with the person who shared this information with you because they have shared with you the greatest opportunity in America today. And business ownership is the American dream. It is the way of the future for all Americans and people who come into our country. But not only here, we're not limited to the United States. This industry that we call the exponential marketing industry, it is available worldwide and you can grow an international business. And listen, we encourage, you know, all of those people who already own a hub. If you got a home-based business already, stick and stay. Hang in there because you did the right thing. Some people, businesses grow fast, some go slow, some grow real slow, and some grow really fast. It really depends on you. You are the X factor in your business because all of these companies that we look for us to go out and market their services, they provide us all the same tools, the same commission schedule, the same marketing, the same website. Everything they provide us is the same for everyone. So the X factor is you. Is how much time you want to put in it and how much time you're willing to learn about this industry that we call exponential marketing. And then also, I want to discourage all of those folks out there that put up negative things up on the internet about multi-level marketing, about it being a pyramid scheme and all that stuff. Look, you need to stop, man. Give it a break. I mean, come on, seriously? For no more money than it costs to get started in one of these things, and you're complaining, and you're going to take all this time out to post negative stuff, man, get a life. Get a real life. You really need to do something different. I mean, because chances are, if you didn't succeed in it, okay, maybe you had a bad sponsor, or maybe the company let you down, or maybe, you did everything they said do, and you didn't make any money. I get that. But there's no need for you to throw the baby out with the water, okay? Don't do that. What we're asking you to do is just move on, find another company, man, because chances are you have that entrepreneur spirit and you was looking for something. And I'm sorry that it failed for you. But listen, let's not destroy the hopes and dreams of people all over the world by posting negative stuff up on the internet. And as we transition to exponential marketing and we're trying to change that image of ourselves, please don't start that up again, okay? Get in contact with me if you want to vent, okay? Let's talk about it. Then also, what we're going to be doing is interviewing an industry expert. As we go into the next year, we're going to be bringing on more and more industry experts, people that are actively involved in different exponential businesses, and they're going to tell you about what they do to grow their exponential business. And then also, I'm going to share my experience. You'll get a lot of my experience because after 40 years of being involved in this industry, okay? And I'm going to share you some of the do's and don'ts and things I've learned. And a lot of things I tell you, things I've actually done myself. So I really want you to get ready to learn. Now I'm going to walk over here and hit my monitor over here because I forget. If I don't continue to change these pages, it'll time out on me. It'll be on my laptop. So, and also we're going to talk about why eHub owners should plug into your eSystem. The systems are so key. Man, if you just get plugged in, and I promise you, if you get plugged in, sooner or later it's going to happen for you. But if you're not plugged in, so someone can figure out where you don't fail short at in the system, or where the system is not working for you, or something, we cannot identify where you are, then guess what? We're not going to be able to help you. But if you're in the system and following the system itself, then we can help you grow your business, okay? All right, now, why should you start an exponential hub, better known as MLM or network marketing business? It's simply because, first of all, look at here. It's free to low initial startup costs. And what that means is you can start your own business, man. It'll cost you a whole lot of money. Some of them are free. And some of you only pay 50, 75, or 100 bucks. Some is two or 300, some is four or 500. But that just depends on the company itself and some of the requirements that they have. But the bottom line is, if you ever wanted to start a business, now is the time to do it. Because you got the right opportunity to go out and start yourself an exponential company, a business. And I'm going to tell you something, you will be able to succeed because everything is for our advantages now. Look at all the marketing tools that we get. Look at the technology that we have. Even if you don't like talking to people or being in front of people, guess what? You can text them, put them on Facebook, just send them your websites through email, text it through email. You can use Instagram. You can blog. I mean, there's so many ways now that you can present this opportunity and build a business. It's no excuse. No excuse for you not to own a business. And look, tax benefits. You get great tax benefits, folks. That's right. You get the same benefits that McDonald's got. All the tax deductions that come with any other normal traditional company, you know, you can get those tax benefits. And listen, I want to add this to it too. Okay, make sure you go talk to a tax lawyer because I'm not there. All right, and I know I'm going into details a little bit more than I normally do, but see, every time someone look at my radio show, I want them to be able to see the beginning of how to get started in this company, as well as those folks who will be looking at it for the second or third time. Okay, but I think it's just extremely important that I emphasize some of this stuff tonight. So training is available to you. Can you imagine? The training is free, guys. You're going to get to learn anything and everything that you want to know about your company. They're going to work with you and train you because they have a financial interest in your success. Okay? In your success. Now, hey, listen. Fun. Dude, ladies, this is a whole lot of fun. I'm going to tell you something. You know, there's not too many things I want to do 40 years, right? To be doing this for 40 years, guys, I've had so much fun, and it's still fun today because I tell you what, as you meet new people, okay, as you meet new people from all around the world, people bringing their circle of friends and family into your world, man, it's exciting, you know? And guess what? You'll be able to help a lot of people reach their financial goals, and while you helping other people reach their financial goals, you can reach your goals as well. Okay, and that's the key behind this business. You help enough people get what they want, you're going to get what you want. And then, if you want to, you can expedite your e-retirement. In other words, hey, listen, you can really speed up your retirement if you want to retire, at least from your current job and start doing this full time. But I wouldn't recommend you do that. My recommendation is, you know, really just go in knowing that you still got your career, you still got your profession, you're not going to change or give that up. Because this is really, you can build this thing part-time and you can make as much money as you want. But everybody don't make millions of dollars, okay? Just to tell the truth about it. Everybody don't make $10,000, $20,000 extra a month. A lot of people make $150,000, $2,000, $3,000 a month. $150 a week, $3,000 a month. Somewhere in between up in there. But you can best make whatever what you want to make. But my point to you is, if you just make extra money on top of what you're already making, life can be really, really sweet for you. And then, of course, some of the goals and dreams that you got planned to get way down the road, 4, 5, 6, you know, 10 years from now, maybe you can get those goals and dreams a little sooner by creating yourself some exponential income, where that you can make an extra $400 or $500 a week, or $2,000 or $3,000 a month. Wouldn't that get you that car you want? Maybe a new home, help your kids go to college, of course. And then listen, this is one of the biggest points here. It's legal. It is legal worldwide. We got companies that's all over the entire world. Network, but you gotta give me a little bit of time to really stop rolling network marketing off my lips, okay? They are building exponential organizations all over the world, and you can too, and it is legal, because we do have doctors and lawyers, we have engineers, we got government employees, we got law enforcement folks, we got people that's in the fire and work for the fire department, we got just about every occupation on the planet doing that owns a exponential home-based business, okay? So no more excuses. It's legal. Yes, did we have some problem years ago with a few shenanigans who really messed up some stuff? Sure, but what occupation does not come with people that will mess things up? Every occupation, I don't care, doctors, there are doctors in jail, there's lawyers in jail. Yes, there are pastors and ministers in jail. And there's, you know, human beings are human beings. And some of them are really flawed, and we as a whole sometimes have to suffer. Okay, but the industry should continue to grow, all right? And yes, you can earn unlimited, I like to say e-unlimited income, and you can earn e-fast start bonuses, e-leadership bonuses that can accumulate to thousands and millions and more. But what I really like is that you can earn e-residual income, which also can go into hundreds and thousands and tens of thousands and hundreds of thousands of dollars a month. Yes, we got people that make $400 or $500 a month, $4,000 or $5,000 a month, $400,000 or $500,000 a month. We even got folks that make over $1 million a month. So it doesn't matter what your goal is. You just figure out what you want to get and let's go after it. Now, tonight, some of the things that we're going to be talking about, okay, and these are some of the topics I'm going to be talking about in my new book, okay, that's coming out. And I got a couple of books that I'm working on. So sometime at the first of the year, I'm going to have a couple of books out. But either way, recruiting techniques, follow-up, no-shows, rejection, you know about the difference between a company versus MLM. I got to change that one topic, that subject, right? Investing in your business, HOT, that's something I created myself in this industry a long time ago. I'm going to be talking about that. Intensified training. A lot of the industry experts, they know about intensified training. And then we're going to also spotlight companies that we are going to be talking about. Also, I'm going to talk to you about some interviews and things. So these are things that's going to be going on and I'm going to be showing you about. Readers and leaders, team awards, sizzle card flyers, and ads, and holiday ideas. So these are all kinds of things, hopefully over the next several weeks, we're going to be talking about, you know, and getting to help you, getting ready to really help you explode your exponential business, okay? So the first thing I want to talk about is the fact that you are a leader. Let me say that again. You are a leader. I believe that every human being on the planet is a leader. And it doesn't mean that you got to be some big-time military leader, some big-time government leader, some big-time corporate leader. Listen, you are a leader and you don't have to have anybody to follow you because we'll all set the example, you know, for someone. There's always someone who respect and enjoy being around you and they get something from you. And that's all it takes. Now, if you want to become a superstar leader, there's a lot of things that you can do to become a better leader. You know, things that we have, you know, proven, have seen that make great leaders. Well, guess what? Some people are born natural leaders. I give you that. But most of them are learned how to be leaders. They take courses, they read great, write kinds of books, and they do all kinds of things to become a leader. But I'm going to tell you some of the things that make a good leader. Integrity, honesty, dedication, commitment, caring about others as well as yourself, being dependable, and being readers. I'm going to talk about readers. Leaders are readers. They are always reading new books and studying and trying to improve themselves. This is one of the number one ways to become a great leader, is that you read about other leaders and the things that leaders write about. If you begin to develop a library and do those kinds of things, you're going to be awesome. You're going to be absolutely awesome because these folks is sharing with you their ideas and things that they have done over the years that made them great leaders. And there's all kinds of great books out there. And maybe in one of my segments I will talk to you about some of the books that I purchased. I got an entire library of books from one end of the wall to the other end of the wall. I got books and books and books. And I'm going to tell you something. It is key to all my success. Okay? Also, remember this. God first. Now, I know some of you may not believe in God, so whether you believe it or not, it's still true. God exists, okay? And I bet you I got more evidence to prove to you that God exists than you do that he does not exist, all right? And family second. God first, family second, and then guess what? You negotiate on everything else. That's right. Don't be emotionally attached to anything other than God and family. That's it right there. If you can understand that concept, you go not allow all this other, you know, noise. I call it noise, right? All these distractions and things that cause you to emotionally be up and down, up and down. Guess what? You don't have to worry about those kinds of things. As long as you focus on God first and family second, God will take care of everything else, man. I'm telling you, God will take care of all that other stuff. I'm not saying you're not going to have ups and downs, but you know what? Life is full of ups and downs every day, all day long. But it's how you deal with it what makes all the difference. That's it, because listen, if you have the right attitude, I mean, sure, you can be down in the valley, but you can be happy in the valley just like you can be happy at the hilltop. And what you have to do is just learn to, when you get in the valley, to know that you, the next stop is the hilltop. And you got to put a smile on your face. And like Les Brown, one of my, you know, guys that I really admire, you know, in the net, that's a motivational speaker. He said, listen, when you're down and out, if you fall on your back, if you fall, fall on your back. Because if you can look up, you can get up. And all I'm saying is just get up, brush yourself off. And there's no need to complain about your problems anyway. You know why? Because see, 50% of the people don't care that you got problems. And the other 50% glad you got them. So you might as well not even, you know, bring it up. All right. What leaders do you admire? Okay. Are they business leaders, you know, that's out there today? These leaders that make billions and billions of dollars, got major mega corporations. What about coaches, high school, college, or community coaches? These are leaders too. What about teachers? Teachers are leaders, okay? They pour into the most important resource on the planet, our children. And I'm gonna tell you something, they gotta be awesome leaders. Teachers are awesome leaders. They don't get paid as much. So all you teachers that listen to this, you probably want to give me a call so I can get you hooked up in an eHub, you know, a business, because you need one, because we really want you to stay focused on the kids, but at the same time, we know you want quality of life. All right, what else? Pastors, yes, pastors are leaders. They lead small congregation and large congregation. And they, I think, as far as I'm concerned, are the most important leaders today on the planet, are pastors, people that's in the ministry, because they're going to lead you to eternal life. They're going to lead you to the next world when Jesus Christ returns. Now, listen, okay, I'm not going to get all into it because I already hit my little inspirational moment, but these guys here, pastors, they're the greatest leaders on the planet. They're the greatest leaders on the planet today because they are the one that building the kingdom for Jesus Christ. All right, politicians, yes, politicians are leaders. We got a lot of negative things to talk about politicians and lawyers, but there are a lot of good politicians out there and there are a lot of great leaders as politicians. And I got up here, MLM leaders, okay? I got to change that one. Exponential leaders. These are folks out there that's leading the way, right? And teaching you the things that they have learned and sharing with you their knowledge and experience. How do you become a leader? First of all, you're already a leader. So the next question would be, how do you become a great leader or a good leader? Well, listen, first of all, you got to recognize that you're a leader. And some of you are bad leaders. But in order to become a good leader, you got to be a bad leader first. And then you become a good leader. And then you become a great leader. But you know what, though? But you got to start off, okay, accepting the fact that you are a leader. And then you're going to grow from there. Okay? And again, you know, to become a leader, I will start with reading right here. But I will also recommend you start by putting God first, family second. Okay, and you can learn about both of these through reading. That's wonderful, isn't it? That's a great connection, ATL. That's real good. Okay, well, what else? Are they born? Yeah, there's some people who are naturally leaders. You know, they have that instinct. They know what to do. They know how to influence people. They know how to get people to follow them. And sometimes it's not even intentional. It's just something about their charisma, something about their nature or who they are. Yes, yes. Are they made? Most of them are made. Most leaders are made. A lot of them go to military schools or management schools or supervisory schools. And then through going through life itself, you know, most adults, grow from being a young man or a young woman, and they grow into mature adults, and they become leaders of their families and then their communities and places like that. So you can become a great leader in our industry. All you have to do is apply yourself and watch those that impress you the most, okay? And look for these characteristics when you're looking for a leader. Okay, now, what we're gonna focus on, some of the characteristics of MLM network marketing leaders. Now keep in mind now, all of this title's gonna change. I just haven't changed all of my content on everything, but I'm changing a lot of this stuff, all right? So here we go. First of all, leaders, always consistently do the following. Now check this out. This is what leaders are doing in our industry, okay? One, they attend training, all right? You must attend training. You must be around the people that got the knowledge so they can pour it inside you. So you got to make sure that you take the time out and attend training. You know, now I know that sometimes it does cost to travel to regional training and national training and stuff like that. But they got training on training, you know, conference calls. They got training on your probably in the back of your websites. They got local training right where you live, and you can conduct training yourself at your home. So there is no reason why you should not be constantly in training. And if you are constantly in training and training yourself, in other words, you are a trainer. Become a trainer, because once you take the time out to learn this information and then you start training other folks, guess what? It becomes second nature to you, and that's going to help you build your business. And again, plug into team trainings, and calls, local trainings, regional training, and corporate training. One of the things that I highly recommend you do, and I don't know if I'm jumping ahead of myself or not, but you really, really need to go to your company's convention. Every year, most of these companies host some type of convention somewhere. Texas, California, or depending on the company, maybe in Las Vegas or Atlanta or Washington, D.C. But most companies host an annual conference where all of their independent representatives from all around the world fly in, man. And that's one of the most greatest events that you ever going to ever attend, because that's the only place I know that you go, that there are people there that want to help you succeed, and they're willing to pour out their heart to you and take the time out to tell you how to build your business and how they have done it. And then not only that, they'll exchange their information. They'll give you their phone number and email address, their business cards, so that you can get in contact with them. That's absolutely amazing, okay? So you need to make sure you get to go to corporate training once a year, and if you know it's on an annual basis, start saving your money. Start putting your nickels together. Open up a savings account for you and your wife, and y'all start throwing in 20, 30, 50, 75, 100 bucks a month so that you have the money that you need to register and go, because it makes a difference. It makes a difference. And listen, I don't get into money for promoting these events, not a dime. And matter of fact, most companies don't even know I'm promoting. Only people that know I'm promoting, you just watching. You need to go to the corporate events, and make sure you plug into all the local stuff. And when you can, go to the regional stuff also, okay? All of this help you, become a great leader and motivate you and inspire you to build your business, okay? Listen, write down your goals and your dreams. I cannot stress that enough. You have to write down your goals and dreams. You got to be ready to share your goals and dreams with others to let them know what you got planned to do so they can hold you accountable. In addition to that, I don't think anything's going to happen unless, you go and write down your goals and dreams. Because in order for it to happen, you got to write it down. And you got to look at it day in and day out. Some people write their goals and dreams down and put it on a sun visor on their car so they can pull it down once in a while and take a look at it and, you know, and read their goals and their dreams. Or they would tape it right there on their dashboard so they can look at it. Or they tape it on the mirrors in their bathrooms or on the refrigerator, you know. And now you can carry it around on your cell phone or you can, you know, you can just got so many ways that you can, you know, have access to your goals and dreams, because that's your motivation. That's your fuel. That's what pumps you up. That's the thing that's gonna keep you going and keep you motivated to want to keep pushing towards your goal, okay? Those things, you know, like if you want a new car or a new house, you want new clothes or a special vacation, if you want to send your kids to college, if you want to get rid of that job, you know, if you want to go and invest into some stocks and bonds and real estate, even if you want to maybe donate more money to your church or charities, I mean, you gotta have some goals and dreams so that you can have something, get up in the morning and be excited about it, okay? Also, grow your list daily. Your list, come on, man. Your list is the lifeblood of your business, meaning that, you know, you don't have to stock products and stuff like that. They used to a long time ago, but your list are the people that's gonna either be your customer or they're gonna be a business partner. So you really, really must reach out to those people. You have, you know, be able to build your list from that, you know, build your list so you can contact those people and give them the invitation. Somebody took the time out and met you. It might have been a family member, it might have been a close friend, but it could have been a perfect stranger where you responded to an ad or something, or somebody approached you in a grocery store somewhere. But the bottom line is somebody shared it with you. And listen, I'm gonna tell you something about going out and meeting people, and I'm gonna do some training on this in the future, right? About how to go out and meet people that you don't know and meet new people, and, you know, in other words, convert people from the cold market to the warm market. I love doing it, I'm good at it, and I'm gonna have a class, you know, where I'm gonna teach about it. I may do a training and invite you to it. But anyway, grow your list. Continue to grow your list, because as long as you got people to talk to about the business, people that you're calling and inviting for them to take a look at your services or your products and or the business opportunity, you're gonna stay motivated. If you run out, then, you know, you may not be too motivated anymore. So one of the first things that you really need to learn, if you already know that you don't have a real list or a network of people, you know you're gonna have to grow a list, okay? What else? Show the plan. Show the plan. STP. Show the plan. Try to do it at least 3 to 5 times a week. It don't have to be a full 30 minute or 40 minutes or 50 minute presentation. It could be a 10 or 15 minute presentation. But first of all, learn the presentation. Learn how to conduct the presentation. Learn the whole presentation. You know what I used to do when I learned a new presentation? I would go down to my basement, set up some chairs, right? And I put magazine pictures or names on the back of those chairs. And I would act like they were people. And I would stand up in front of them and I would give the presentation. Now here's the key. First of all, while you practicing, nobody's gonna say anything to you. The second thing is, when you do it live in front of some people, they're not gonna know if you messed up or not. They're not gonna know if you made a mistake, as long as you don't say anything and let them know. Because I promise you, if there's somebody in the room that knows, chances are they're one of your partners, but they're not gonna embarrass you in front of the people. They may correct you later. But the key is practice. Practice. Practice the presentation. Because that's when you become from a dependent representative to an independent representative. That means you can do the presentation anytime, any place, anytime, anywhere, for anybody. And once you learn how to do that presentation, you're gonna be just fine, okay? What else, HL? Okay, look, going back, read positive books. Leaders are readers. Listen to wealth building audios. Hey, listen, you know, we got books now, just about all the books are now been placed on audios. So that means that you can pop a CD in your car, or you can have it already on your iPhone or on your Droid. You can have music. You can have all this stuff, technology you have. You can now take advantage of it and grow yourself exponentially. Let me say that one more time. You can grow yourself exponentially. So based on the technology that we have today, where maybe 30 years ago, it might have taken someone 10, 15 years to be making a certain amount of money. Well, guess what? Because of technology now, you can probably do it now in 3 to 5 years, or maybe even shorter. You know, the way that you can communicate and reach out to people now, you can contact people faster and quicker and a lot more because of technology. That means that you can also grow yourself, right? You can grow yourself and become a better leader because of all the technology that we have, that you can sit and learn and learn and learn. Education and information, you know, that can change your life in a lot of different ways. So listen, you really, really, really need to get involved into the technology and start taking advantage of it, just like I'm doing right now. Look at me. I'm at home, right, shooting a live broadcast all over the world. This broadcast is going to be going to every state in the United States, and it's available in all like 139 countries. All you got to do is log on to the internet, and you can watch me. That's all you got to do. And if you're watching me now, then chances are you logged on to the internet, right? Okay, but of course also there are people going to be watching this video later on, because once it's over with, it's going to be posted up on YouTube, and you can watch it at my YouTube channel or the radio station's channel. What else, HL? Look, network with other team members to get ideas. Listen, no one has all the knowledge about all the different ways and ideas and stuff to do anything. I don't care what it is. I mean, in the legal field, engineering, medicine, you know, in the food industry, transportation, it doesn't matter what it is, because we are constantly evolving, getting better and better, and people coming up with new ideas every day. You know, I know some of you probably thinking that there's nothing new to learn, right? You know, all these people have become millionaires and billionaires, and they don't thought of everything. Wrong, wrong, wrong. There's always something new for you. All you have to do is to pursue your dreams and goals and be willing to go after it. But network for other people. Get ideas. If you can't come up with your ideas, by you going to training and plugging into training, bam, that's how you get some new ideas. And one of the things that you should do when you are in training is that while you're listening, don't try to write down everything that they put up on these slides or whatever. You can always get a copy of the slides. But what you should be doing is, when you hear something and it gives you an aha moment, make you think of something or a good idea, that's what you write down. Write down the ideas and things that come to mind when you are in training. Right? You can, like I say, most training people got slides and things that you can get copies of. But what you want to capture is your thoughts. Write them down, whatever they are. Okay, because that's the important thing about it. Now, provide positive information to your downline and direct the negative information to your upline. Yes, there are ups and downs in this business. I told you that, right? Because we're human beings, so it's always going to be ups and downs. But in building an organization and being a great leader, always pass positive information down to your team. You always give them positive information. Negative information, pass it up to your upline. Now, in theory, that's what we're supposed to do, right? But your person that's in your upline might have just joined a business the same day that you joined yourself. And they might can't handle the negative stuff. Okay, so we got to be a little careful, though. You got to analyze your audience, all right? But you can go further up to people who've been in the business for a while, or do what I do a lot. I don't talk about it to my upline or my downline. I talk it over to some colleagues in my crossline. And I talk with them about any issues and concerns that I may have. And we work it out together. right? So that's just a couple of ways of things that you could do in order for you to keep the negative information, because you don't want your team to get negative and start quitting or slowing down as you try to build momentum on your team. So just, you know, take your time, you know, go talk with somebody, work it out, okay? And look, never, and then never quit. Listen, there's no reason for you to ever not own a business, and don't quit. Once you become a part of this industry, this exponential marketing industry, you have yourself an e-hub, an exponential home-based business, stick and stay till you get your pay. Don't give up. Don't quit no matter what. Yes, you may have some people quit on you, but don't you ever quit on yourself. You may even have some of your upline people quit, but don't you quit. You just hang in there. Now, let me clarify. Yes, you may want to leave the company that you with and go to another company. Well, that's fine. That happens all the time, okay? Until you figure out the company that you want to stay with. But don't quit the industry, though, and don't quit the company that you're with until you have identified the new company that you want to be with. Why? Because you may not be making money, but you definitely can be saving money, okay? And you probably will be able to take advantage of all the tax write-off, okay, until you transition to another company. And usually, you can do it overnight. So don't get mad and emotional, okay, and then make a bad decision, say, I quit, I'm not gonna do it anymore, I'm not going to any more meetings and no more training and all of that. Think, talk to someone first, okay? Get with them and work it out before you just give up in this industry, because it ain't costing you much money. And training is free, it's definitely a lot of fun. And you get out your house and go to some of the trainings and stuff, you get to meet a whole lot of new people. And if you're serious about building your business, you're gonna meet a lot of new people every day. And I'm gonna tell you something. There's people that I've met all over the United States and around the world, and they're still friends of mine. We may not be with the same company anymore, but we'll create a long-term relationship. And a lot of these types of networking opportunities that you get will cross over into your personal life, and there's things that you get to meet, be able to do, because you know so-and-so who's in the same type of business that you're in. It may be a realtor, you may find a doctor or a handyman, you may find a lawyer, you may find a business owner, and they give you discounts because you're part of their team or something, or that they know that you're in the same organization or whatever. But there's a lot of fringe benefits that come with this. So I highly recommend never quit. Don't ever give up, because if you do, you're gonna regret it. Just stick and stay, and I promise you, you'll get your pay. Well, ladies and gentlemen, listen, I'm done for tonight. Hey, listen, I have a great time. I really enjoy this. I got some other things I'm gonna talk to you about next week. Like, for example, some more characteristics of leaders. You know, they do it first, and, you know, they're constantly always out prospecting. You know, hey, look, I got some great information. So make sure you tell somebody about Dr. HL, Our Power, okay? Because I'm going to give you an hour of power, and I hope I've encouraged you tonight. I hope you really, really enjoyed the information, and I look forward to seeing you at the same time, maybe not at the same place, but I'll be right here providing you a roadmap to success. So that's all I have. So listen now, you take care, and I'll see you at the top. HL is out. Money.
money, 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 money.